There are various properties of images formed by spherical mirrors: the position, the size, and the nature of the image. These properties vary as the object's distance from the mirror varies. The property that we are going to discuss in detail in this video is the size of the image. For a concave mirror, there are three possibilities for the size of the image relative to the object. Basically, the image can be enlarged, the image can be of the same size, or also can be diminished or smaller in size. For a convex mirror, the image is always smaller in size unless the object touches the mirror. In that case, the image will be of the same size as the object. Now, if we were to compare the size of the image with the size of the object, then we will take their ratios. That is, the ratio of size of the image to the size of the object. And this ratio is what we call magnification. It's denoted by the letter M. Let's move to a new page. In our ray diagram, the sizes of the object and the image are nothing but the heights of the object and the image. So M will be equal to HI over HO. Let's do a bit of math now. Suppose the height of the image is greater than the height of the object. This means that the image is enlarged. Now answer this question. If the term in the numerator is greater than the term in the denominator, then the ratio will be? Yes, their ratio will be greater than 1. What if HI is less than HO? Yes, the ratio will be less than 1. The image is diminished. What if they're equal? Their equality implies that both the object and the image are of the same size. The ratio will be 1. If you notice that in all three cases, we are assuming something. We are assuming both HO and HI to be non-zero. But can they be zero? We know that when the object is at infinity, its point-sized image is formed at the focal point. So here we can take size of the image as zero. However, theoretically, we say that when the object is at infinity, the image is point-sized. But in reality, this is not a point-sized image because we cannot define infinity. The image, however small it is, still has some dimensions. So in reality, HI cannot be zero. It can be a really small number, for example, 0.00005, but never zero. We can apply the same logic for the object size. So HI and HO cannot be zero in reality. Now there is a relation between the magnification and the object distance U and the image distance V. The relation is that HI over HO is equal to negative V over U. This relation is very easy to prove. I will give you a rough sketch of its proof in another video in this playlist, but first, let's solve a few problems based on magnification. Here's the first problem. We will see the solution in the next part of the video.